Hey everyone, Troy here from Shift Automation. Happy to show you the first in our new line of linear actuator controllers. There's no programming or funky wiring required. Simply connect the actuator motor and feedback wires and you're up and running. This controller has been in the making for some time now, primarily driven by our customers as well as people who have reached out to us looking to control the position of their actuators. At Shift Automation, we love to help people, as corny as that sounds. So after hearing from so many people, we knew we needed to do something about it. Without getting too technical, we built a simple-to-use position controller for linear actuators. As I mentioned, no programming is required, and no funkiness with dozens of wires dangling all over the place. Simply connect the actuator wires and the power wires and you're up and running. We built this controller primarily for Shift Automation linear actuators, because of course we want you to use our actuators. However, we knew there would be situations where customers would have their own actuators. Shoot us an email at info@shiftautomation.com to discuss how this controller can work with your actuators. The controller is very compact, about 7 by 8 centimeters, or 2¾ by 3¼ inches. It has several mounting holes to provide flexible mounting options. An enclosure will be available shortly. The feature I love best about it is that there are onboard buttons available for all 5 positions, as well as set, retract, and extend. This means you can quickly bench test the controller with an actuator without hooking up a bunch of buttons. This also means you can install only the buttons you need for operations and use the onboard buttons for the initial configuration. That said, it's really quite simple to add buttons to the control board. There's a screw terminal pair for each button on the control board. You simply connect 2 wires from the button. Bear with me. And you're up and running. The button has to be a momentary button that is normally open. If you're not sure what normally open means, it's basically that there's no connection across those wires until you push the button. Feel free to ask if you have any questions. For those more tech savvy, the grounds for all buttons are common, so you can just use a single ground wire out to all of your buttons to make a cleaner install. So you just run one of the ground wires out and then one wire for each button you want to use. We have some stainless round push buttons available, as well as momentary rocker switches, but you can use whatever buttons you like. For system integrators or people who want to trigger the functionality from another system, a simple contact closure or relay could easily be used in place of a button. This would work with relays and our remote control system as well. We'll have another video on that shortly. In terms of operation, it's really quite simple to use. Just use the onboard buttons or your external buttons to retract or extend, find a position you want to save, hold down set, press the position you want associated with that. Let's just do another one, set position 2, and now we can go between position 1, position 2, just like that. Obviously works for all the positions. There are no rules. Position 2 doesn't have to be after position 1. It can be any random position. Let's just set position 3 as... Now we go 1, 2, 3. I hope this quick demonstration helps you understand whether this controller is the right solution for you. We've got a number of videos in the works, including one showing the expansion board for this controller that adds 8 more positions, as well as some custom project examples with small touchscreen displays. I know we're all inundated with channels asking us to subscribe, but if you'd like to see more from us, please hit the subscribe button. We appreciate it.